Vern was just a regular boy. Like any other kid, he liked to play sports with his buddies, but something was always a little odd about Vern. You know, every time he'd fall down, every time he'd get hurt, he'd just get right back up and keep playing. People thought maybe it was kind of odd, but they just let him be and went on with the game. That is, until one day, when Vern decided to go to his doctor. There, he made a discovery that would change the course of his life forever. This is Vern's story.
The doctor will now see you. Hi there, I'm Dr. Jungian Shiz. What's your name?
I'm Vern.
Well, nice to meet you, Vern. Let's just give you a checkup here.
Okay.
Okay. And let's just do some tests. Oh, wow. Well, it appears you have several broken bones and minor concussion in the back of your head. Your lips seem to be very chewed out. And, well, I'm going to have to run some electrophoresis gels because you may have a very rare genetic disorder. Well, I ran my electrophoresis, and I'm sorry to tell you, you have CIPA.
You may be wondering, what is CIPA? Well, CIPA stands for Congenital Insensitivity to Pain with Anhidrosis, and is characterized by two main symptoms. One, the inability to feel pain, and two, the inability to sweat. The young man you see here, Vern Small, has been living with CIPA for 16 years. What follows is the story of his life.
You know, I remember the day that me and Pat here found out that little Vern had CIPA. It was August 21st, 2007, and we came into the doctor's office. We thought it was just a routine checkup, and by the end of the day, the doctor told us, well, little Vern has CIPA. Well, what's CIPA, we asked, didn't we, Pat?
Yes.
And Dr. Shez, he told us, well, CIPA is a genetic disorder, extremely rare, that causes the subject not to be able to feel pain or to be able to sweat. And, you know, I thought it was terrible. How are we going to deal with a child that can't feel pain? He means constant surveillance. It's really a living hell.
Well, ever since we've known of Vern's volatile illness, we've tried to do the best we can so that he can just have an ordinary lifestyle. We've built him a pool in our backyard so that he can exercise without overheating or getting in serious pain. Oh.
Hello, I am Norman Post, and I am a geneticist at the Bard College in Portland, Oregon. I have been studying CIPA for over 20 years. It is a very, very interesting genetic disorder to me.
Most scientists agree that CIPA is caused by a mutation of the NTRK1 gene, the gene responsible for encoding the receptor tyrosine kinase, which regulates nerve growth. NTRK1 is located on chromosome 1. As of 2004, 17 different mutations of the NTRK1 gene had been shown to cause CIPA. Studies have shown that mice lacking the NTRK1 gene do not feel pain, proving that this is the gene responsible for the disease in mice as it is in humans. This mutation causes structural abnormalities in the peripheral nerves that carry electrical impulses from pain-sensitive nerve endings, rendering them unable to send pain impulses to the brain. Normally, these nerves, when stimulated, would cause the brain to make you feel pain, therefore causing a reaction that ends the harmful activity causing the pain. The nerves themselves are intact, but a defect in the central nerve structure makes their messages meaningless.
As you have seen from my incredible presentation, CIPA, or congenital insensitivity to pain with anhidrosis, is a very, very hard disease to live with. And it has just taken the lives of so many people. Thank you.
I am very small. I have lots of trouble talking because I chew my cheeks and my tongue. I can't even help it. It's like I'm going to chew a hole in my mouth. But I just can't stop. Well, people like to pick on me because I'm really different from the other kids. And, you know, they beat me up a lot. You know, they like to throw things at me and call me names. But, you know, it doesn't matter. It tells me that I have to get help. I can't even feel it. Like, I get a broken ankle one day. I couldn't walk, but I had no idea. Well, I can't be in the sun very long. Because my blood, it gets really hot, as the doctor said. I overheat, and I can't feel, but sometimes I just pass out if I exercise a lot, and it's really bad. They say it's bad for me. I think it's bad for me.